and welcome back to Sherma SJCU's podcast, our Bridging the Gap podcast. Today, I have Sam, our VP of Communications, and Monique, an active member of SHRM. She's involved in our involvement committee and a part of our buddy program. She reached out to me actually about doing a podcast for Dressing for Success. So here we are today. So Monique, go ahead and tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, as you mentioned, I'm currently in SHRM and a junior at San Jose State University, majoring in HR. But fun fact, I actually started in fashion way, way long ago and even had my own fashion line for a couple few years. So one of the questions that I normally get is, what is business casual? What do I wear? And I geek out on many fashion things and many other subjects. So it's a fun topic for me to talk about, and it's one that I find very important, especially in our end of college careers and through the rest of our lives. What is appropriate to wear to work, to a function for networking? And I know that SHRM, we have a lot of those.
Yeah. So this will be really helpful for all our members listening. You know, you're thinking like, oh, what does business casual mean when you go to an event? Maybe it scares you away from even attending, but we're going to help you present yourself in the perfect way. So to start off, we're going to do a little icebreaker and share what we think is hot and what we think is not in business fashion. So for me, I think fresh face makeup is really hot. You want to make yourself, like, for me personally, I like to feel good when I go to work, having a nice foundation, but not doing too much. You know, this is not my time to show off my glittery eyeshadow and my really super pigmented highlight. I just want to look nice and presentable. For what's not is too much perfume or cologne in the workplace. I try and be really considerate of people who may have an allergy to fragrances or are just too are sensitive to this. So, you know, try and keep it to a minimum and just, you know, stay fresh. Monique, what do you think is hot and what is not?
Well, what I think is hot is, a lot of things, but... there's something to be said about having a fun piece to your wardrobe that you wear that shows a part of your personality. I know I have a lot of fun things, but a lot of times you'll see me with my Pokemon backpack or a Pokemon bag. That's my fun piece, and I think that's hot. What I think is not, too skimpy of clothes. Leave something to the imagination. And honestly, it looks a little bit more polished in my opinion when you're a little more covered up. It just depends on what you want to present. But if you go too far, are you really wanting to present that part of yourself?
Yeah. How about you, Sam?
Yeah, for me, I mean, I can speak to what I think look good for guys. I think like having a really fresh cut or like a fade looks really clean. I know some guys get it like every 2 weeks and that's pretty expensive. I personally cut my own hair and I don't really know how to do like a fade, but I think that looks really good. Like when guys have a really like fresh cut, you're just like, ooh, man, they look professional.
I noticed it too, so.
yeah, everyone noticed it. What's not hot? I think just like when like facial hair isn't super kept, or like for myself, like I don't grow the most, it's kind of sparse. So like I can't let it grow out too much or it's definitely noticeable. Yeah. Like if you can like grow a beard, just make sure like it's clean. And yeah, not like unruly.
Yeah, definitely. So yeah, so those are some of our opinions on what we think is hot and what's not. I mean, obviously it depends on where you're going, but in the business world, I think these are some good tips to follow. So up next, we're going to be kind of interviewing Monique and what her experience is and what she thinks is appropriate and what's not. So why don't we start off with a quote you told me when we had a meeting beforehand. And you said attire is on a scale and not in boxes. What did you mean by that?
So what I meant is it's like a spectrum. So on one end, you have your casual yoga pants, PJs. And on the other end, you have your black tie formal. Like if those are your bookends, fashion kind of falls on a scale in between. And so there's no one particular spot where you're like, this is business casual in this box and only these items. Mm-hmm. So when you look at like information blogs, they'll say, well, you have your nice casual, you have your business casual, you have your cocktail hour dresses, you have your formal dresses, and it gets really confusing. So I think it's important to think about like, what do you have in your closet and what's one up from that? And that'll probably be the appropriate. So we're talking about business casual. If you have really nice dark wash jeans that don't have any holes and you can dress it up with a nice t-shirt with a collar or a blouse, things like that. So on a scale versus a box.
Yeah. As a member, when I was just a member in Sherman, I would go to the networking events or anything like other professional workshop. I would be like, ooh, what do I have in my closet? You know, like I have slacks, but do I want to do a more basic sweater? Because, you know, it can be expensive for you to pick out really nice pieces. So do you recommend, how do you go about shopping for these pieces, but like still being on a good college budget?
Well, I'm going to plug the Career Center because they have freebie things that are really nice.
Yeah, perfect.
So we have access to a nice wardrobe where we can find those, some of those key items like a pair of black slacks. If I'm going shopping and say I have to redo my whole business casual wardrobe, then I treat it more like a capsule wardrobe where I pick maybe 5 to 7 pieces to have in there. And it may seem really basic to have just a pair of black slacks, a pencil skirt that's appropriate for the office, a blouse, a button shirt, and a nice jacket. But it's a great foundation to start from.
Yeah, I completely agree. Sam, do you feel like you have a good foundation in your closet, or do you think that you'll have to kind of do a little bit more exploring to establish that good closet before you enter the workforce?
Yeah, I actually think, so last summer I had my first internship, so I kind of did a little bit of shopping. To answer like your former question of how to keep a budget, I think the thrift store is a great option. Yeah. I think it's a little harder to find pants at thrift stores. That's like what I've noticed. But like you can find a lot of good like tops for guys, like really nice button-ups. Like I found like, I think like a lot of like at least 25 to like 40% of like my closet of like business casual is like from thrift stores. And like it's honestly amazing. Like thrift stores are already cheap as is, but if you go like when they have sales, like I'm coming out of there with like 5 new tops for under $20, you know. It's like insane.
Yeah,
most people haven't done that.
Yeah, I don't know if many college students like are taking advantage of thrift stores, but what I found is like if you just go to the good thrift stores, sometimes in more affluent areas, like they have designer. And you can get like a nice sports jacket and it's like brand name, you know? Mm-hmm. So definitely take advantage of that. So another interesting point that Monique brought to me before was it depends on the region you're in, what business casual can really mean. So can you go into that a little bit more?
Of course. So it depends on where you are in the world. So if we just take the United States, for example, West Coast business casual is very different from New York business casual. And that has to go with the mentality of the area you're in. So for example, in New York, business casual, you would never wear jeans, no matter dark wash, no matter how nice they are, you would never wear jeans. You'd always wear slacks and a polo shirt, or if you were a guy or a girl or anything in between, or you would wear a maybe a nice black pencil skirt and a blouse. So that's more New York, in my opinion, and from my understanding. Whereas in California, we're much more laid back. Think about how we have a lot of culture that's surrounding surfer and Hollywood, as well as right now in the Silicon Valley, there's the Google culture. So there, it's a little bit more relaxed. So you can wear a nice dark wash jean, no holes, please, no holes, and a blouse or polo shirts if it's a little more of a casual function, so to speak, for a business casual, or if it's slacks and a nice button shirt for something that might be a little bit more formal.
Yeah, that's something I've noticed too, like just working on campus, and we have our professional staff in the office on Fridays, they, you know, wear jeans and maybe a nice sweater or a dress. So it's interesting to see, like, if I go to New York, I better make sure I have a pencil skirt instead of, like, my nice jeans.
Yeah, definitely. And yeah, just thinking about where we've come from. So my father used to work at HP in the 90s, and it was always suit and tie, button-down shirts, and their casual Friday was fun tie Friday, and they'd wear, like, ugly ties and whatnot. So when you look at now, where it's like, what's casual Friday out at Google Complex, someone might be in their sloth onesie. So yeah, it's changed a lot. And again, it is dependent on the culture and where you are.
I think that's a great point. Yeah, we've come a long way. Like now it's like Facebook, Google culture, you know, you can wear a t-shirt and jeans. Sam, did you have something to add?
Yeah, I just think it's so funny because, or I think it's like different, like in our sector as HR, I think we always kind of have to like dress a little more up. Yeah. But, you know, I have a lot of friends who are engineers or like are CS, and, you know, they just go into work with like flip flops. Like it does like not matter like what they wear. It's like so different. I remember like in my internship last summer, like I was in HR, so I kind of dressed up a little more. But everyone else that were interns, like with all the other engineering departments, you know, they were just wearing like t-shirts and like hoodies, and it didn't matter at all. And I think it's just so different, like even just within like the different sectors of the business.
Yeah,
that's definitely a point I'd like to highlight also. It really depends on what the career and job position is. So accountants probably don't have much of a business casual because you'll always be in a suit. Or lawyers don't have too much of a business casual because they're in courts. Usually it is much more professional in a court, in the sense of an engineer going to work in flip-flops and jeans and a t-shirt.
Yeah, I completely agree. It's, I think as future HR professionals, like Sam said, we're always gonna kind of have to dress up because we're establishing the tone for the rest of our employees. And we want to be professional at all times. Let's talk about how to step it up and dress more professional. Like maybe if you're going to an interview or if you're even unsure of what the dress code is and, you know, how to always just make sure you're presentable.
So did you want me to kick off that question?
Yeah,
shake it up. Okay. So if you are ever in doubt, take what you think you want to wear and step it up one notch, in the sense of if you think that it's okay to go to your interview in dark wash jeans and a blouse, switch it out for a pair of slacks. Comb your hair, please. You know, really what it comes down to is what fits you best in your personality as well as your physicalness. Ill-fitting clothes speak different things about you. Sometimes it's not the biggest thing, but just take that extra moment to give it a little polish. You know, wear your nice shoes.
Yeah. Sam, what do you think?
Yeah, everything that she said. But I think also, like, for guys, like, if you're, I think normally for interviews, you should be wearing, like, a suit, like a tie, of course. But making sure, like, your suit is fitted, so, like, making sure, like, your shoulders align. I know, like, you can find a lot of cheap, like, suits in the thrift store and then just get it tailored. And it's still cheaper than buying it, like, new at, like, the outlets or something. Because I think, like, having a fitted suit, like, despite, like, the quality, like, it just makes you look good. And I think in addition to everything that Monique has said, like, something that makes you, like, confident, I think is a lot too, because like if you don't feel confident in what you're wearing, then like figure out what helps you be more confident in that interview.
Yeah,
if you look good, you feel good. If you feel good, your confidence is going to show through.
Of course. I definitely agree on those things that you're all saying, I want to share some stories that I've actually experienced when it came to seeing people getting interviewed. So I helped check people in for the program that I was in last year for their interviews this year. And so, you know, we would have our candidates line up. And one of these guys, he came in just cargo shorts and a t-shirt. And he looked around at the rest of the candidates and we're like, oh, in the email, it didn't specify the dress code. And, you know, it was kind of awkward and I felt really bad, but I was like, you know, just make sure in any interview you go to, any business setting, like you should step it up. You know, this is your time to present yourself. And especially it was a panel interview in front of 15 people, like a first impression. Oh, really, yeah, it's really going to matter. And he just made it worse by just like saying like, oh yeah, I'm just going to say that I didn't know. And so I was like, no, that's not an excuse. And I was like, just stop. I was like, I think this was a good learning lesson for him.
Yeah.
The person that checked in right after him was another male candidate in a suit, had a nice portfolio. His hair was nice and combed back. And he was just like, oh, and I was, exactly. Like, you need to be prepared for your competition and be able to like make that good first impression. Following like what makes you feel good, another colleague of mine, her favorite color is yellow. And she would always wear that. And although you may think it's like a loud piece, like she found like the perfect tone that matches her. And she would wear that to feel confident in business settings. So those are some things to keep in mind from those people's experiences. Sam, what did you want to add?
Yeah, and so actually for my my interview for my internship last year, in the email they sent me, they said business casual. And so I was like, oh wait, business casual, that seems like a little dressed down. But of course, like I dressed up like in a suit. And I think a lot of people are concerned with like, oh, what if I'm more dressed up than who I'm interviewing? Like, isn't that a little awkward? But I'd say like, that's okay to do that. If anything, that just shows like you like rose to the occasion, you're taking it seriously. And I think it's often common that you are more dressed up than your interviewer, and that's okay.
Yeah.
I would definitely agree with that. On average, you know, I do my whole like business plus one notch for my interviews, and I'm a little bit overdressed for interviews sometimes, but it's okay because I feel better. I've taken that extra time. I actually have a story from a friend that I used to work with that took it too far. And it's hilarious. He did get the job. Let me just start with that. He did get the job, but he was applying to be a dishwasher and he came in a tuxedo.
Oh,
wow. So that was a bit much. I believe he went because that was the only nice thing he had, for whatever reason. He didn't have anything in between jeans and a t-shirt and a tuxedo.
Hmm.
But he was remembered. And ultimately he got the job, but it was just really funny on the blow it out of the water with a cannon, baby, like come in a tux for your dishwasher job.
Yeah.
So,
well, I'm glad he got the job.
Yeah, you better get the job.
Because one thing I thought of was like, I think the only time that it would really be inappropriate is when you go too far, but in that circumstance it worked. Because I think for females to go too far, it'd be like wearing like a gown, you know.
Exactly.
I don't think anyone would do that.
Yeah,
hopefully not.
I mean,
but I'm sure everything has happened at least once, so
yeah, I'm sure it's happened out there, I'm sure. But it's interesting also to see just when you go into say Kohl's or Target, like that's a good kind of middle ground, affordable for college students. When I go in and I look in the Mrs. department and even the junior department, because sometimes there's a little bit of a crossover depending on your comfort level and age bracket and what you find. Sometimes there's a gem there. Sometimes there are some longer dresses that are okay for office wear. But they're definitely more polished. They're not too low cut. They're not too see-through. So there's a lot of criteria that need to be checked off, but yeah, it's not like you're wearing a sequined ball gown, say that 5 times fast, to your interview.
Yeah. Let's go ahead and switch to like getting those staple pieces. In one of our workshops before, a professional mentioned that you should invest in those staple pieces because they'll last you a long time. Mm-hmm. But getting feedback from students, we were kind of like, well, I can't get like a $200 blazer, even though I know it's going to last me like 30 years, you know? So right now, you've mentioned the Career Center, which is a great resource. If you all have questions, I recommend just going up there. Like, the people are super friendly, and three of the SHRM officers work there. So yeah. You should definitely check them out. They have a lot of resources. But like you said, like Target, Kohl's, H&M, a lot of like Ross, Marshalls, you know, I think you just have to do your digging. But like Sam was saying, like going to the thrift store is fun. Yeah. It's like, you know, you can find a lot of cool stuff, and you may get like a nice designer piece. Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah, just I think later on in life, I would splurge and get those nice quality items, like a nice pair of heels, slacks, blazer. But right now, I don't think so, because I'm just going to go and find whatever is like under $20, because anything over $20 to me is like expensive. But yeah. I think it's great. You know, it's great. We have to continue to make ourselves feel good and do that in our own ways. Sam?
Yeah, like, I think for guys, it's like, I feel like girls, like, you have so many, I don't know, there's so many different options. Kinds of, like, clothing. Like, I don't even know what there's you guys wear to interviews.
Yeah.
But for guys, like, you can find a black suit easy. Like, that, you can find that, like, anywhere. And just, like, having just one that fits you, like, you'll be set for, like, mm-hmm. till the end of college or whatever, you know? So.
Yeah.
I think you should always have, I think everyone that's listening to this podcast should have their staple outfit, you know, that they can run to when they have an interview or they're going to a networking event. So that's an action item for all of you. Mm-hmm. Is there anything else that you two want to add?
Well, I, like I said before when we talked, I could go on for an hour and a half, and maybe that's a whole other thing, and people are always welcome to ask me for more specifics, but definitely, if I had to pick key items, black slacks, a nice pencil skirt. I have a black one, so it's like black slacks, black skirt. Easy to dress up, dress down. A blouse that's not too low cut, or if it's a button one, there's a 4-inch rule from your neckline, and that helps kind of keep it more professional. And then a blazer, if you can afford one. If not, I have a really nice cardigan that's a pop of color. So with a white blouse, I have a teal cardigan, and that kind of is a good start. One note that I want to add is if you're trying to do something that's a little more polished and you are a woman or a man, if you wanted to, and you're wearing a skirt, invest in some stockings or nylons. That extra polish really helps go a long way. And fun fact, if you wanted to know, if you're in a hurry and you haven't had a chance to shave your legs, pantyhose goes a long way in making life easier. I know we're always on the go, and I know that's probably like, oh my gosh, I feel like I need to shave. It's like, don't worry about shaving your legs. Put on some pantyhose. Nobody will care. Yeah. And you'll look more polished. Mm-hmm. So.
Yeah, my aunts totally do that. They work in a bank, and they have to wear pantyhose. One of my professors said, like, we all, us ladies, I think, you know, we've kind of overlooked this. You know, we wear our pencil skirts and stuff, but make sure to get yourself a pair of nice pantyhose for your next interview, because not only does it make you look more polished, but from what my professor said is that it keeps everything in, because you don't want to be, she was really blatant about it, and she was like, you know, your butt is going to shake, so you want to keep it in. She was quite a character. We love her. Yeah. But yeah, that's a great tip. I think that's another staple piece aside from all of that. You know, guys, that you have your basic suit, maybe a nice polo, nice slacks. Girls, you have a lot of things that you can choose from, but make sure you get your pantyhose. And Sam, You want to add anything to that?
Yeah, I mean, I'll speak for the guys. But I think if you like want to just kind of do a little more than just like your basic suit, I think finding like brown shoes, doesn't even have to be real leather, but like brown shoes, brown belt. I have like a reversible one that's black and brown, so there are plenty of those in stores nowadays. And then if you really want like a statement piece, like I think finding like a watch that preferably like a leather band that matches your shoes and your belt. But like I think having like a watch that is, and what's the word for not digital, analog? The watch that you can see, that you have to count.
Wow.
You guys know what I'm talking about.
You're so, I can't even remember. I call it a face watch. But
face
yeah.
watch, yeah. But I know like some of people, they have like an Apple Watch, like you can easily find like leather bands that match. Like I have a Fitbit and I just found like leather Fitbit bands on Amazon and I was able to find one that matched.
Yeah. This is a Fitbit Flex one and it's got little rhinestones and it looks way more polished than just the.
Oh, wow. Yeah, it does. I thought that would
do that.
That option too.
I think that's great. You know, step it up in any way you can if you want to.
Yep. And so I'm glad you brought up the shoes because I was going to bring that up. If you were trying to decide on a shoe, a black leather shoe or doesn't have to be leather, is an easy one, especially since it goes with most things that would be in your staple business casual wardrobe. I am a big fan of a nude color shoe or flesh color shoe. And there's a whole long theory behind that, but essentially it goes with everything and it makes you look taller and therefore thinner and leaner. And it doesn't have to be a heel. It can be a flat. It depends on your comfort level and what you're going to be doing. If you're running up and down stairs all day, maybe don't go with the 6-inch heel.
Completely agree. Gosh, I don't want to ever wear heels to work. Like I'd rather just not. So I think we're gonna finish it up here real quick, unless any of you want to add something. We're gonna be giving our final piece of advice, so maybe this is your chance. But I would just say be confident in what you wear and be comfortable in it. Like we're just talking about the heels. If you can't wear heels, you know, stick to what you know. Monique, what is your final piece of advice?
Be yourself. I think that kind of harkens to what you were saying a little bit. When you're being yourself and authentic, that's really going to show through more than any other accessory or special designer pants that you bought for $500 on your credit card. I think that is a good place to start, and then your best accessory is your smile, and that is something that goes a long way as well. So that would be my parting thoughts.
Great, thank you, Sam. What is your final piece of advice?
Yeah, for me, I think guys, just go to the thrift store. Maybe bring like a friend who knows what's up. Maybe bring your mom. Bring like some girl that knows how to make you look good, and just. Yeah, don't wait the weekend before your interview to buy your professional thing. Like, you know, get those in advance, find if it fits, you know, and yeah, take advantage of like these cheap stores that offer that in the career center. So yeah.
That's great advice. Oh my gosh, I'm so glad that we all got to talk today. And thank you again, Monique, for coming with me and collaborating and sharing all your thoughts and experiences. We really appreciate it. And Sam, you're awesome. We all know. All right.
Thank you, Mariel.
if I can add one thing that is kind of a life quote, definitely I learned this quote in fashion school, but it's heard all over. It's from Coco Chanel. And she used to say, before you leave the house, take a look in the mirror and look at yourself and remove one item. And that really speaks to the simplicity of just feeling confident, making sure you're not overdoing it, making sure you are taking that last moment. And as always, keep it cool.
There you go. You all heard it here. I hope you all take this advice and you feel prepared to come to our next networking event, even though maybe like next year, we don't know. But even when you do like your interviews and stuff, you know, you'll be more prepared. To close off, we're going to give a quick shout out to a couple members and a couple officers. So Vivian and Kaylee, thank you for being active members in SHRB, in the Buddy Program. Really appreciate your thoughts and your positivity. Officer shout outs. Shout out to Teresa and Sean. They helped put together the awesome HR panel that we had, and they did amazing. So we have a lot of more events coming up soon. So just keep that in mind. Follow us on our social media. And that is it for today. Thank you all for listening, and we'll hear from you all soon. Stay healthy.